Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the compare to function, okay, and we'll also see compare to ignore case. So let's see the syntax. The syntax is like this: string 1 dot compare to string 2, okay. Now this compare to function, it compares both the strings lexicographically, in other words in dictionary order, okay. For example, if we take any two words like apple and mango, so this apple word comes before the mango word in the dictionary, okay. So we'll say that this apple is smaller. This apple is smaller than mango, okay, and this mango word is greater. It's greater than apple in the dictionary order, okay. So now, if we look at the syntax of this compared to the function, if we look at the prototype here, you can see that it requires a string input as a parameter, okay, and it returns me an integer value. So what does this integer value represent? Let's have a look. So we can have three cases, okay. First case is this one: if the string 1 is greater than string 2, the result will be greater than 0. Okay, the result will be greater than 0, and we'll discuss later what this number will be, but it will be definitely greater than 0. The second case is if string 1 is less than string 2, okay, that means the answer will be less than 0, a negative number, okay. So if we take the example of apple and mango here. So if I compare apple with mango, so apple is smaller, okay. So apple is smaller, so I'll get a negative number, okay. And if I compare mango with apple, that is in string 1 we have mango and in string 2 we have apple, okay. So the result will be greater than 0. Let me write it down here. If I do mango is greater than apple, okay. So this will return me a value greater than 0. And here in this case, in the second case, if I write apple is less than mango, okay, the answer will be less than 0, okay, a negative number, because here string 1 is less than mango. In the dictionary order, apple comes before, so we'll say apple is less than mango, okay. And if finally the third case is if both the strings are equal. If both the strings are equal, the result will be 0, okay. And when we say dictionary order, okay, so there is one extra rule here. That extra rule is this one, okay. Capital letter comes before small letter, okay. Capital letter comes before small letter. So if let's take this one, okay, apple. First string is apple, and if I compare this with the second string, okay, so what will happen? This apple, the first string has got capital letters, isn't it? So this one will come first. That means this capital letter apple is smaller than the small letter apples. Okay, so that is the extra rule regarding the dictionary order. In a normal dictionary, we don't care about the case. But here in Java, we have to compare. We have to take into consideration the case also. Okay. Now let's see a few examples. So, first example is this one. Here in string S1 I've got apple, in string S2 I've cat, in string S3 I've got cat. Okay. Now let's talk about S1 and S2. Okay, S1 compared to S2, S1 dot compared to S2. We are comparing S1 with S2. So the comparison will happen like this. First, the first difference of letters, okay, the first difference of letters is taken into account. Okay, so the first difference is occurring right here at index 1 only. Okay, so right at index 1, the first difference is occurring. That means we have different letters. We have different letters. So as soon as we have different letters, I will get the difference between the ASCII values of those letters. So what is the ASCII value of A? The ASCII value of capital A. So the ASCII value of capital A is 65, okay, and C will be 67. So S1 comes first. So 65. Okay, capital A 65 minus 67. Okay, so the answer is what? -2. So if I compare S1 with S2, the answer will be -2 if the string is apple and cat. Okay, remember it's case sensitive. So -2 is the answer. And if we compare S2 to S1. Okay, that means first string is cat and the second string is apple. Okay, this time it will be 67. Okay, 67 minus 65. So this time I'll get the answer as 2. Okay, and third case, we are comparing S2 with S3. So S2 and S3, they both have cat as the string. So this time the answer will be 0. So the answer for A will be -2, the answer for B will be 2, and the answer for C will be 0. So now I hope you understand that what is that integer value returned by the compare to function. It is the difference that is occurring between both the characters at first difference. So let's have a look at the output. Let's call the example 1 function, and here you can see the output is -2 and a 0. Let's see the second function. In the second function example 2, okay, I've got two strings, bat and bought. Okay, so first of all, first two characters are compared, they are same. Okay, so nothing the JVM will check the next two characters then. Okay, the characters at index 1. Okay, at index 0 the characters are same. Okay, so nothing will happen. The next index will be checked. The next index we have different characters. So as soon as we have a different characters, the difference will be given, the ASCII difference. So capital A is 65 and capital O is 79. Okay, so the difference will be 49 if we compare S1 with S2. Okay, and if we compare S2 with S1, then it will be opposite. 79 minus 65, that is positive 14. Okay, so in the second example we are comparing S2 with S1, in the first one we are comparing S1 with S2. So the result should be minus 14 and plus 14. Let's have a look at the output. So example 2, which we are getting minus 14 and plus 14. Okay, let's see another example. So here we have got two strings again. In S1 we have apple, in S2 we have apple. Okay, the case is different. Okay, here we have got all the characters as uppercase, and here we have got all the characters as lowercase. So what will happen? The first difference is occurring right at the first index. Okay, so capital A is 65 and small a is 97. So the answer is minus 32. Okay, and the reverse, when I compare S2 to S1, it will be 97 minus 65. So here we will get positive 32. So let's have a look at the output. So the answer is minus 32 and plus 32. And we talked about the dictionary order. I told you that capital will come before small. Okay, so we are getting when we compare this capital apple with small apple. Okay, we get a negative number, which we discussed here. Okay, we discussed here that if string 1 is less than string 2, we'll get a negative number. Okay. And let's change here, let's change it to bat. Okay, so this time what will be the answer? The first difference is occurring right here. Okay, so here we have got 65 and here we have 98. Okay, so if we do the subtraction, we'll get 3 here and 3 here, that is minus 33. And if we compare S2 to S1, okay, it will be 98 minus 65, so that is positive 33. So this time we should have minus 33 and plus 33, as you can see in the output. Okay, let's see the last example for this compare to function. Here we have got mango in S1 and Madras in S2. Okay. So here the first difference between the characters is occurring at the second index. Okay, so the ASCII difference will be given between n and d. So n, small n, is small n is 110 and d is 100. So 110 and this one is 100. Okay, so the answer will be 10. For this we'll have 10, and for this we'll have the opposite. So as when you compare Madras with mango, then it will be 100 minus 110, so the answer will be minus 10. So the answer should be 10 and minus 10. Okay, so as you can see in the output window, the answer is 10 and minus 10. So I hope you have understood the compare to function. Okay, now now the next function is compare to ignore case. Okay, this one, compare to ignore case. So the syntax is exactly same. The only difference is that this compare to ignore case, as the name suggests, ignores the case. So let's come to this apple example. Okay, both the strings have apple here. This one is capital apple and this one is small apple. Last time we saw that the output was minus 32 when we compared S1 with S2, and it was positive when we compared S2 with S1. Okay, let me show you again. example 3, when I'll call the example 3 output. So minus 32 and plus 32. Now if instead of using compare to, if I write here compare to ignore case, okay, compare to ignore case. So this time there will be no difference. That means both the strings are equal. Okay. So as you can see, the output is 0, and that is our third point, isn't it? That if both the strings are equal, then the result is 0. Okay. So it is just like comparing like this. So this time I've removed the ignore case, and this time I'm just using compare to. So here both the strings are same, isn't it? So here the output will be 0 again. So let's see this. It's 0, isn't it? Okay. Now let's bring our ignore case back. Okay. And let's change it to small apple. Okay. This time also we are getting the same output. We are getting the output as 0. Okay, so compare to ignore case, if you do not want to consider the case, then you can use this function, and it will give you 0 if all the characters in both the strings are same. So this was compare to ignore case. Let's see another example, one more example. Okay, let's take bat and bot again. But this time bot will be in small letters. Okay, last time it was in caps. So that, let's see the output for this first. This is example 2 function. So example 2 function is minus 14 and 14. Okay, now if I make this small, okay, so where is the first difference occurring? The first difference is occurring right here, isn't it? So capital B and small b, the difference will be minus 32, isn't it? So minus, the answer for this will be minus 32, and the answer for this will be positive 32. Let's have a look at the output first. So as you can see, minus 32 and positive 32. But look what happens when I use compare to ignore case. Okay, compare to ignore case. So as soon as I do that, that means now the case will be ignored. Okay. Okay, and let's change the string also, bot. Okay. So here we have capital B and we have small b. So both will be treated as the same only. Okay, they are same, zero difference. Okay, now in the next one we have capital A and we have got small o. Okay, capital A and small o. So here the difference will be minus 14 plus 14. Okay, how is this happening? Capital A is what? So capital A is 65 and capital O is 79. Okay, so we can treat both the letters as same. Okay, capital in our string we have small o, but we can treat it as capital O only because we have to ignore the case. Okay, so either you take capital O and capital O, or you can take small a and small o. Okay, so here this is 65 and this one is 79, so minus 14. Okay, and if you take the smaller case, this one is 6 This one is 97 and small a, sorry, small o is 111. Okay, so in both the cases, you can see that the difference is minus 14. Okay, so S1, when we are comparing to S2, ignoring the case, okay, the answer will be minus 14, and when we compare S2 with S1, ignoring the case, the answer will be plus 14. So, let's have a look at the output. As you can see, the output is minus 14 and plus 14. So, I hope you have understood both compared to and compared to ignore case. So, I will stop here. Thank you.